Hello, in this video we are going to show you all arthroscopic treatment of type 3 tibial plateau fracture without using fluoroscopy and hardware for fracture reduction and stabilization. When the diagnosis of type 3 tibial plateau fracture is made based on the imaging evaluation and confirmed during arthroscopy, additional working portals should be created to achieve proper access to the posterolateral tibial plateau. At first, the midlateral portal is created 1 cm anterior to the popliteus tendon. Then the arthroscope is introduced to the posterior medial compartment and the posterior medial portal is created. The instrument cannula is inserted to maintain portal and facilitate maneuvering. Then the radiofrequency probe is used to make the transseptal portal. It is important to have working edge of radiofrequency probe directed anteriorly away from popliteal neurovascular bundle. Now, looking through the transseptal portal, the posterolateral portal is made. The radiofrequency probe is used to perform partial lateral capsulotomy. Bone chisels introduced at first through the midlateral portal and then through the posterolateral portal are used to mobilize and elevate the posterolateral fragment. The fracture reduction should be observed with the scope in the anterolateral viewing portal. When the correction is accepted, the first biocomposite interference screw introduced through the posterolateral working portal is placed in the bony defect underneath the posterolateral fragment of the tibial plateau. Then the arthroscope is moved through the anterolateral viewing portal to the lateral recess, and the second biocomposite interference screw is placed underneath the posterolateral fragment through the midlateral portal. At the end, we control the result of surgery. Here you can see the results on the X-rays and CT scans 2 months after surgery.